Let's try silver. Okay. Gold? Oh boy.
Yeah, sketchy products like this metal detector here are not uncommon on AliExpress. And in case you're wondering, AliExpress is a Chinese online store where you can find the newest, weirdest, and also sometimes super useful products. But there is also lots of garbage on the site, which is why in this video series, I have a closer look at intriguing looking products in order to tell you whether you should check them out as well or stay away from them. And today I got 6 more promising products to check out. So let's not waste any more time and let's get started.
Designing advanced electronics just got easier with JLCPCB, who are my long-term sponsor. Now by using them, there will be no more routing challenges or similar, because their 6-layer PCBs are not only cheap, but right now you can also get a $30 coupon for them. This means you get significantly more routing space, which allows for more complex designs, high-density components, or intricate trace patterns, while still featuring minimal interference. And with their rapid 24-hour turnaround, you can get your PCBs super quickly. So why not try it out today by clicking the link below. Now let's get started with this handheld induction heater tool that you can get for around 187 euro. So definitely not cheap. But on the plus side, I can say that it made a rather good first impression, with its nicely made enclosure, the manual tells you all the important details on how to use it properly and safely, and you get a total of 6 coils with 3 different sizes, so that any bolt and nut fits inside. This is important because, as you probably already guessed, this tool is used to heat up old and rusty bolts and or nuts. This way the nut expands and thus can be more easily removed, which, let me tell you from experience, is not always easy to do when it comes to old mopeds or similar. So to try it out, I inserted a fitting coil, plugged it into an outlet, positioned everything correctly and pushed the power button. And yes, after a couple of seconds, the 40-year-old dirt around the bolts started to smoke. And at this point, it was truly a bit easier to remove the nut. This heat-up process, of course, also worked with other stainless steel bolts and nuts, which obviously heated them up, but I was missing the notorious red glow. For that, I had to switch over to heating up iron, which was not the product's fault, because this is simply how induction heating works. And if you want to learn more about that, then feel free to watch my previous video about the topic. But anyway, after heating up quite a few things, I gotta say that this tool didn't feel sketchy at all. Instead, it feels well built and pretty safe to use with its active cooling. And for the last application test, I wanted to see if it can beat Loctite, which makes it almost impossible to remove a nut once it's hardened. But as you can see, with a bit of heat, the Loctite smokes a lot and loses its grip. Very nice. So last but not least, I had a look inside and was happy to see that not only a bit of protection was integrated, but also that the circuit and components all looked pretty decent. And that means this thing gets a thumbs up. And the only negative aspect is that it is not very cheap. So moving on to something much cheaper, which is this Wi-Fi weather station that you can get for around 11 euro. I got interested in it because someone from my Discord server recommended it, and I also really do like its looks, and I feel like it fits perfectly on my workbench. To use it, we simply have to power it via USB-C, connect to its access point, and then configure it using a web user interface, which sadly it didn't work with my smartphone though. However, it worked perfectly fine with my PC. And thus, after adjusting these settings to my liking, I got this awesome looking weather station, which, like expected, fits perfectly under my PC screen. This is not the end though, because after taking this thing apart, we can see that it simply consists of an ESP8266 and a screen, meaning we should be able to upload our own code. And of course, people on the internet already did that, meaning I firstly followed this guide here to hook up a USB to serial converter, which I then used to upload the given example code. And yes, that worked perfectly fine. But what I was more interested in was using this display to showcase data from my Home Assistant system. And the Home Assistant community is already pretty active here. But sadly, after quite a bit of testing, it seems like my version of this weather station is not ideal for this application. You see, I got the Ultra version, but the Pro version would be more suitable, because even though it is a bit more expensive, it comes with an ESP32 inside. This makes it possible to more easily display data, and that is what I will get next. But even with this downside, I would still give this Wi-Fi weather station a thumbs up. Next, I got myself this handheld metal detector that can detect copper, silver, gold, and dime, which are apparently precious stones according to the manual. But anyway, you can get this thing for around 97 euro, which is certainly not cheap. But I always wanted to find treasures in my garden, and hopefully with this thing I can do that, because it can supposedly detect up to a maximum depth of 20 meters, and it comes with a search range of 1000 meter. So let's start with the positive by saying that it was packaged very nicely. Charging the internal batteries did also function without a problem by using the given 12 volt charger. And that is where the positive stuff ends. Because next I opened up the main unit and material selector unit in order to find out whether the batteries feature 1000 milliamp hours or 1600 milliamp hours. In case you're wondering, it is 1000 milliamp hours, but that is no longer really important, because both circuits look like hacked together sketchy useless stuff. I mean, the main metal detector circuit is a rather simple LC oscillator circuit that has a very limited range, and can only detect metal if there's quite a bit in front of its antenna. And I especially love that the material selector LEDs are not connected in any way to the main metal detector circuits. Combine that with a scanner LED that always follows the same light pattern and a horrible range between selector unit and main unit, and you got yourself a useless product that will most certainly not find you any treasures, unless you're directly touching them. All in all, this is the worst product I reviewed so far in this series. So let's move on to something hopefully useful, which are the smart LCR tweezers that you can get for around 29 euro. Now for that price, you certainly get a good quality looking product here, whose display is very bright and easy to read. Such tweezers are obviously quite useful when dealing with SMD components. And the idea here is that you can easily determine their values. And since we got an LCR meter here, it can measure inductance, capacitance, and resistance according to this range and accuracy charts. It can also measure continuity and diode voltage drop, which both works just fine. What was more important though was the LCR measurement. And for that, I prepared a couple of components for testing, which I firstly measured with the tweezers and afterwards with a more expensive LCR meter. The results showed that measuring the main component values with the tweezers was definitely good enough. Only when it comes to the extra values like series resistance or coil quality, I would not quite trust the tweezer results. But anyway, since this thing was pretty intuitive to use and you can charge up the internal battery fairly quickly. I would recommend having it around when working with SMD components. And that brings us to the fifth product, which, as you can see here, comes with some accessories, like a big tripod and a huge kind of like ruler, as well as of course the main big box, in which we can find a rotary laser level. Now I got all of this for a price of around 216 euro, which recently climbed up though to 250 euro, which again is not cheap. But if you look at other rotary lasers, then you quickly notice that this thing is by far the cheapest you can get. And the reason why I got interested in it is because I want to put up a 21 meter long fence here. The problem is though that my ground is certainly not completely level when traveling 21 meter, meaning I will need a level reference point at the start and end, so that I can adjust my fence according to that. So to do that, I first had a closer look at the laser. And I gotta say that with the given manual, it was super simple to understand how to use it. Before doing that outside though, I charged it up with the given charger while having a look at the remaining given stuff, which was not that important, I think, except for the laser receiver. By attaching that to the ruler from before, this thing basically beeps and shows you how to position it so that the laser beam perfectly hits it in the middle. So time to do the outdoor tests. And for that, I used a stake at the right and left side with the laser in the middle that dictates at which point both stakes are level to one another, which I then mark with some tape. And to prove that these tape spots are truly level, I next used a hose water level whose ends I simply attached to the stakes before filling it all up with water. As you can see here, on one side we got a reading of around 4.1 and on the other around 3.8, which equals a misalignment of 3 mm, and that is definitely good enough for me, considering that this error is probably caused by me by fiddling around with the stakes or placing the tape a bit incorrectly. So overall, this laser does its job just fine, and from my amateur point of view, I can certainly recommend it. And that brings us to the last product, which is probably the beefiest power strip I've ever seen, that you can get for around 79 euro, which in direct comparison to other power strips is super expensive. Now the product description justifies this price point by saying that it adapts a two-stage EMI filter and high quality wiring on the inside. Before taking it apart though, let's firstly plug it in order to find out that the socket's got juice and it displays the RMS voltage at the front here. Why is this necessary? I have no idea, but it looks nice. But anyway, next I tried opening this thing up, which was not that easy to do, since some screws were kind of locked into place. Eventually though, I got it open, and initially the wiring did look promising, because the conductors were definitely thick enough and the crimped connections looked nice. However, the socket itself uses screw clamp connection, which, as you can see, resulted in some loose connections, which I definitely do not want to have in my power strip. That is why I would always recommend such spring-loaded sockets. And last but not least, we got the two-stage EMI filter, that even comes with overvoltage protection at the end here. After reverse engineering its schematic, I gotta say that it truly is a two-stage EMI filter. Like, for example, this one right here. In one of my previous videos, I showed off how such a filter can help to get rid of interferences, meaning having such a filter is not a bad thing. However, if I combine all the facts here, then I gotta say that I would not recommend this power strip. And just like that, we covered 6 more products from AliExpress. And like always, I'm happy to say that some were truly useful, and I'm looking forward to using them in the future. Of course, there's much more to discover and try out. So, like always, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you don't miss the next episode. Stay creative, and I will see you next time.